James, don't be so difficult. We both know Tony and Diane cannot know we stole those accounts. I mean, obviously I deal with it myself, but we both know that I am not the one who's got Scott eating out of the palm of his hand.
It didn't stop him taking the laptop and tottering off, did it? What if I had plans today?
I thought you had a couple of days' holiday.
So did I.
Oh, darling. All you have to do is convince your admirer not to spill the beans to his employer. And then you can carry on doing whatever it is you do on your days off. Oh, sweetheart. I will call you when I get back from town. A bientôt.
You're right, Scott. How are you doing? I thought we might catch a drink later if you fancy it.
Bet you thought it'd be so easy, didn't you? Hmm? You just turn on the charm and I'd fall to my knees and keep yesterday to myself, is that right?
Wait, you said you'd give me a chance to explain, so let me. I didn't mean any harm. I had to see those accounts. I had to see that the place my mum has a heart set on was a reasonable investment.
Well, why has she got a heart set on it? It's Tony's, not hers.
This is going to sound stupid, but her dad, my granddad, owned a restaurant. And since he died and it closed, all she wants is one of her own. Name it in his honour. Live up to her old man.
You better not be making this up.
Give me some credit. Anyway, none of that matters because I can't let her bid on this place, not when it's going under.
What?
Scott, have you seen the accounts? Take a look for yourself. The hutch is on its last legs.
What?
But to be honest, unless fortunes turn around soon, the hutch is closing down.
Hey, darling, I'm sorry I can't stop. I've got to meet Diane for a drink. How'd it go, Scott?
It won't be a problem. This is Diane who you're planning on pushing out of a restaurant, yes?
James, I haven't got to where I am today without failing to keep my enemies close. Oh, well done, you getting Scott to keep quiet. talk of the devil.
Hi, handsome. Fancy a drink? Celebrate me pulling in a big wedding contract for the hutch at short notice. Oh, yeah. Well, the client's on a bit of a budget, so I said I'd do it for 200 quid.
Oh?
Yeah, I know it's a bit ambitious, but I thought...
Ambition's the only thing that's going to save that restaurant.
My thoughts entirely, James. That's why I'm going to be the man to save it. So I'm sorry, love, but it looks like you're going to have to set your sights on some other place because the hutch isn't for sale. Oh, but I just want you to know that whatever you do, I'm sure your dad would be mad proud of you. Drinks.
My dad?
Yeah, about that.
No, I really do not want to know. But you heard what he said, though. I think we have the key to the hutch.
Like taking candy from an idiot.
Ah, that will be Diane about tonight, I'm sure. Do you know, if we have a good time, I think I might let her stay on and work for me. Well, after I own her restaurant, of course.
You really are a piece of work, Mother.
Oh, darling, thank you. I mean, I know. Obviously, I know, but... always nice to be reminded. Mm. Bonne soirée. Mm. Diane, darling. No.
Well, not a patch on mine, but c'est la vie, as they say in sunny Newcastle. Cheers.
Any reason why you're choosing to spend your days off hanging around here?
I thought you'd be grateful for the extra business with that smell you got going on.
Dirk's gonna deal with that.
Afternoon?
Yeah.
You fancy a game?
Sure.
I'll beat you like I used to beat my younger brother.
You're so full of it.
Hi. Oh, what's that smell?
Ah, that's just James. He's staying with us at the moment. So, you're set for the wedding tomorrow? Where's your fiance? Oh,
last minute stag do.
The day before the wedding? That's brave. I wouldn't count on him making the actual ceremony.
Yeah, he's just winding you up, Jason. He'll be fine.
My fiancé is far too sensible to get himself into any trouble, all right? He's a policeman.
Oh, good. That proclivity for handcuffs will be helpful when he's cuffed to a lamppost with no clothes on.
Aw, this is cute. Nice to watch my two brothers get on.
Yeah, this isn't cute, yeah? This is me teaching my cocky older brother a lesson and getting too big for his boots. And I'll thank you not to distract me.
Mm.
What a sore throat.
This guy.
Dirk! How goes the search, mate?
Well, found your problem.
Scott.
Trying to keep a low profile.
Where from?
I didn't tell Auntie Diane about the catering for the wedding, so she's banned us from the kitchen. And now, Cindy, that's the mother of the bride, by the way, well, she's threatening to have us hung, drawn and quartered unless I can magic up a set of canapés and two main courses out me backside by 11. Everyone at the wedding's gonna starve to death.
Well, let's not get carried away.
Scott, one of the deliveries has been cancelled, so now I've got to drive all the way to the wholesales and get it myself. I know, so can you do me a favour and keep an eye on the place for me?
Yeah, sure.
Great, I won't be long, OK?
Looks like a handsome young chef we know is back in the game.
What, me?
What are you waiting for? Good looking, get in that kitchen, start cooking. I'm right behind. Okay, canapes.
Finito.
Main courses?
Almost finito.
Excellent. Look, I'll swing by later, okay?
James!
What are you doing in my kitchen?
What I do best, Auntie Di. Mincing away till me heart's content. What are you doing back so soon anyway?
Well, I didn't want to leave you on your own for too long. I went the offie instead. Oh. Scott, that's Philip's tea.
How is it?
Yeah, and that's Tony's dead posh vintage wine.
Well, nothing but the best for these wedding guests.
Wedding?
Yeah. I got us a deal to do the catering for Holly and Jason's big day.
Oh, go on then. How much?
200 smackaroonies. Cindy's even thrown in 50 quid up front.
Oh, no, please tell me that you haven't agreed to do all this for 200 quid.
Well...
Get out.
Well, I just need to...
Scott, get out of the kitchen. Do you know that business is all we've got? And if anything happens to it, we could all be out on her, yeah?
What, like homeless?
Yeah. We borrowed money against this place, haven't we?
Oh, well, if I'd known that, I would have tried to get us some more dosh out of Cindy.
Well, you messed up, didn't you? So just accept a little bit of responsibility.
All right, so I messed up. But I'm not the one who's flushing this business down the toilet.
Sorry, what?
Nothing, it doesn't matter.
No, it does matter. You just said the words business and toilet. So go on. Scott!
Look, I'm no Alan Sugar, okay, but I've seen those accounts. And a minus is still a minus, isn't it? We're in serious trouble, Auntie Di.